Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install PostgreSQL on a Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install PostgreSQL, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply search with PostgreSQL download and hit enter, and you'll be getting this www.postgresql.org as your first search result. Here you need to just simply click on this download button, and you will be getting this official site of PostgreSQL, and depending upon what operating system you use, Linux, macOS, Windows, or you know this operating system, you should be downloading your PostgreSQL. Now here I am using Windows, so I'll simply click on this Windows, and it will redirect you to this Windows installer, and here you can see that there are so many versions available for PostgreSQL, but version 15 is also released, so which is not updated yet. It will be they're going to update very soon. So to download the 15th version, you need to click on this download the installer, and it will going to redirect to this page. So here you can see that all versions are available for download, okay, and from here the latest version is 15, and you can see these are all operating system. So from here I'm going to choose the Windows, so I'll just simply click on this download button for version 15. So I'll just simply click on that, and it will going to redirect to this EDB site, and it will going to start downloading our PostgreSQL. Now since I have already downloaded it, I'll just simply cancel it, and I'll just simply minimize my browser. And if I go to my download directory, you can see that latest version of PostgreSQL 15 is rightly downloaded over here, and the file size is 313 MB. Okay, so after downloading, you need to just simply double click on the installer, and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and you can see that our PostgreSQL installation wizard is rightly opening. Okay, so let's minimize our download directory, and this is our PostgreSQL installation wizard. So just simply click on next. This is where the PostgreSQL install actually going to happen. So they're going to create this PostgreSQL folder and the version 15. So everything is fine. Just simply keep this default and click on next. So here you can see that they're also going to install our PostgreSQL server, which is like the main thing. And then they're also going to, you know, install the GUI component, which is our basically pgAdmin 4 version 4. And they're also going to install Stack Builder and command line tools. Everything is pretty much important. I'm going to show you some of these items. So for that, just stay tuned to this video and click on next. So here is our data directory. So in our, you know, I have shown you that they're going to create this version 15 folder. So after that, they're also going to create this data folder. So where all our data are going to be reside. Okay, so keep this default, click on next. And here you need to, you know, type a password. This is very important step. Do remember this password. You will need this every time while logging in your, you know, PostgreSQL. Okay, so remember this password. So, you know, just simply type all that and just click on next. And this is our port number. This is also very important. 5432 is, you know, the default port number for PostgreSQL. So this is also will need like when you'll try to communicate with your code to the backend. So you'll need this port, okay, to establish the connection. So this port number is also very important. Okay, so now just simply click on next. And in advanced option, you can choose the locally. For now, I'll just, you know, simply keep this default. Later also you can do, not a big deal. Just simply click on next, and see, it's almost ready to be installed. Just simply click on next. Yeah, ready to be installed, next, and our installation has rightly begun. So this installing PostgreSQL will take some time, you know, some minutes, 3 to 4 minutes I would say. So after that I'll be coming back. Yeah, so welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Postgres is almost installed, and it is asking that whether you'd like to, you know, check this stack builder and proceed. So, you know, you don't need stack builder right now. It's going to install some drivers. So I'll just show you once. So if you just simply check this and click on finish, you will see here, like you can install these drivers. So for now you can skip this part and just, you know, simply click on cancel, so that, you know, you don't need stack builder right now. So our PostgreSQL is rightly installed along with our pgAdmin. So I'll just simply, you know, search here pgAdmin, and you'll be getting this pgAdmin 4 over here. Shouldn't you just simply click on that to, you know, launch our Postgres or, you know, pgAdmin GUI interface. And you can see that our, you know, pgAdmin GUI interface is rightly open. Remember the password you have given. So you need to type that same password and just simply click on OK to, you know, get into our pgAdmin. So let's maximize it. And this is basically the interface of our pgAdmin. So here is our server. So if you just simply click on this drop down, again, it will ask for that password, same password. So you need to retype that again. And you can save this password so that you don't need to, you know, type that again and again. So just simply click on OK. Server is connected. So you can see that Postgres 15, which is the latest version, is rightly there. Then our database is also there. So if you just simply expand our database, you can see they have already created a database called Postgres. Okay. So here I'm going to show you how we can easily create a new database. So for that, you need to just simply click on this database. Then right click and create and database. So here let's give the database name as new DB. Like it's totally your wish. You will be giving your database name. If you switch to, you know, SQL tab, you can see the code beneath it. Okay, creation of the database. So let's switch to general tab. So you can just simply use this GUI interface on creating the new DB. Just click on save. And there you go, our new DB is rightly created over here. So if you expand our schemas, you'll be able to see like there are so many things like aggregates, you know, different things, and the main thing is this table is there. Okay, so views are also there. View is like little, you know, high level. For now, let's stick to tables only. So here is our table. If you expand it, here you'll be able to see all columns and all once a table gets created. So for that, you can create table by just simply right clicking, and you can create table from here as well. But I'm going to, you know, show you how you can easily create scripts and all. So you need to, you know, click on the database, then right click, and then you need to just simply, you know, click on this create script over here. So once you create that, it will going to, you know, open a new tab over here, and here is basically our query section. So here you can do everything pretty much. Like I'll just simply hit a couple of times enter, and I can, you know, create our table over here. So I'll just simply type create table persons, let's say, and I'll be simply giving a couple of columns for now. Person ID, int, and I'll be, you know, giving a full name. Okay, for now, just demo purpose. 255. So here is our script. Here is our script for creating of a table. So just simply click on this run button, and there you go. It has, you know, rightly executed successfully. So if you go to table and if you refresh first this and click on this drop down, you can see that our persons table rightly created. So if you create more tables, it will going to show that. You can expand column also. You can see that this two column we have created is rightly there. Okay, and you can do several things, like you can insert data in the table, you can, you know, fetch, and can you can do like pretty much everything like you do in you know, SQL. So you can do all that over here in this query window. Okay, so that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you, you know, want more videos on PostgreSQL, then please do drop a comment in our comment sections. I'll be happy to make those videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.